In this movie, a taxonomic identification of the preprocessed sequence readsets of the mice gut samples will be calculated. The 16S identification analysis in BioNumerics relies on two reference files. First, the alignment algorithm implemented in the metagenomics analysis requires the presence of a template alignment, also called reference alignment, which is used to align sample sequences to. Second, the methods implemented to obtain classification results on the read sequences rely on the presence of a reference taxonomy to obtain a taxonomic label for each of the read sequences. First, we can check the presence of the uploaded reference alignment. Thereto, I select Database, Sequence Databases, Reference Alignments. When selecting one of the loaded reference alignments, detailed information including the alignment length and the number of sequences is displayed at the right. Similarly, we will check the loaded reference taxonomy. Selecting a taxonomic database from the list updates the number of taxonomic levels that are defined and the number of sequences included. With the reference alignment and taxonomy database imported, we can start the identification analysis. A new metagenomics project can be initiated from the main window, the sequence readset experiment window, as well as from the metagenomics window. In this example, we will start the analysis from the sequence readset experiment window. I click the colored dot of the trimmed sequence readset experiment type to access the data. Under Analysis, I select Identify against taxonomic database to initiate the wizard. The first question asked is which way operational taxonomic units should be defined. The first option will identify the sequences against the reference taxonomy and create OTUs from the obtained taxonomic identification results. By choosing the second option, distances between unique reads are calculated, and based on the calculated distance matrix, a cluster analysis is created. For each cluster, the sequences are identified against a reference taxonomy, and OTU assignments of the clusters are based on the taxonomic identification results. Next, the sequence clustering parameters should be defined. I leave the sequence identity threshold at 90% and I specify a final sequence identity of 95% for the sequences in the obtained clusters. And finally, the reference alignment should be defined. Once the clusters are calculated, their sequences are identified against a taxonomic database. In this page of the wizard, the taxonomic database can be selected and the analysis levels can be specified. We will limit the identification levels from bacterium, phylum to genus. The results of the identification are OTU abundances for each of the phylogenetic levels. These data will be saved to the BioNumerics database as character sets. One character experiment will be created for each phylogenetic level included in the analysis, and within one experiment, each character will represent one OTU at that phylogenetic level. With the default option, we let the software automatically decide to which character experiment the data should be saved to. I can press Finish now to start the analysis. After confirmation, a dialog pops up asking if you would like to run the metagenomics analysis in a dedicated window. Clicking Yes starts the calculation in the metagenomics window. The calculations are organized in different project tasks, illustrated as blocks in the project pipeline. The progress of the calculations can be followed on the progress bar. Each time a task is completed, a green V sign is shown. Once the project calculation has finished, an overview of the generated results which are a range of different visualizations, datasets, and text tables, is present in the Data Source Overview panel. With these data sources, a number of predefined reports can be generated. To create a report from one of the templates, click the Add Report from Template button. Depending on the available data sources, different templates become available and are listed in the Create Report dialog. As a start, we will create the input report for the current dataset. The input report displays charts on sequence length, sequence quality, the number of ambiguous bases in the reads, and the maximum homopolymer length. The second report that can be called is the OTU report. We only want to look at the data of the unique reads and the reads at 97 and 92% similarity. In this report, an overview is given of the different OTUs that are considered for each of the similarity levels. The rank abundance overview, indicating the number of OTUs for each level, and the species abundance overview, indicating the dominant OTU size for each level, are displayed next to the individual rank and species abundance curves for the specified similarity levels. The last and probably most interesting report for this analysis is a taxonomy report, which will give us an overview of the taxonomic information present in the sequence readset. In this example, I will only display the taxonomic identification results for a similarity cutoff at 97%. The taxonomy obtained for the complete readset is displayed on top, and just beneath the taxonomy on the 97% similarity level. Next, the different taxonomic distributions on each of the phylogenetic sublevels are displayed in detail. When we go back to the taxonomy tree at 90% similarity, you notice that by default all levels are displayed in the taxonomic tree, which renders a rather small picture. However, this can be changed from the taxonomic tree window. I select this part of the figure and I press Open the selected components in dedicated window. In this window, we can change some visualization filters. First, we can define the minimum OTU's abundance as 2% of all observations. Next, we can limit the visualization depth. We will start from class and end by family. This updates the view in the taxonomic tree window. A last setting that we can change is add the relative abundance values next to the OTU name. Thereto, we open the display settings and add the relative abundance label. For more information on the settings in this taxonomic tree window, we invite you to check the dedicated information under the Help function, which is available within each window. When we close the taxonomic tree window, the tree in the report is updated to the customized visualization. To complete these results, the corresponding single sample diversity analysis can be calculated as well. For more information on this type of analysis, please watch our movie on single sample diversity analysis. When closing the metagenomics window, we return to the main database view, where we can have a look at the character experiments that were created. In the Experiment Types panel, a new character type is now listed for each of the phylogenetic levels that was used in the analysis. For the database entry that was used in the analysis, we see that the OTU abundances were saved as character data in the database. Note that analysis on sequence readsets can be initiated on multiple entries simultaneously. Thereto, select all the entries that you want to use in the analysis and select Analysis, Sequence Readset Types, Identify against Taxonomic Database. Press Next. Next again, and finish. This will start the calculations without opening the metagenomics window and launches one metagenomics analysis after the other. Once the batch analysis is completely calculated, all OTU abundances are present as character data and can be used for further analysis in, for example, the comparison window. The data can be visualized used for clustering, or further used for PCA analysis, MANOVA analysis, or other statistical analysis.